audience, and I'm always like, curses! I wish I could fix it, but I can't.
You? I haven't caught any snakes.
You're lucky.
Yeah.
I'm sure they exist.
I'm sure.
Yeah. More questions, please.
Yes. Yeah, yes.
What do you want to hear? What line?
Anything you don't like doing. I feel like
is it a bird's strength is not in the branch? I don't even remember, man.
Just say that.
I don't even remember her voice. What does she say? Y'all!
Perfect!
Oh, no. A bird, what? What's a tell you line? Huh? Say what?
Oh.
Throw another stone!
Yeah.
A bird's trust, a bird's strength is not in the branch. Sedimentary, my dear Malphite. She has like really funny little things like that.
Yay.
Yes, well. That's her like master or whatever, but yeah. I also sing her login theme.
Yeah.
I sang that thing, yeah.
Yeah, when people ask us to do lines, we sometimes blank.
Y'all, this is like a lot of you.
Happens to me every time.
But I was really proud of the work I did on her. I really, really liked it.
Yeah.
Thank you. That's so kind of you.
Behind you, yes.
So, I'm a huge fan of your line.
Oh, are you? That's weird.
Do you ever watch it prior to actually recording, so that you know what you're supposed to be feeling?
I like to know, with your line, you probably watched along, but I knew what happened in the end, because I think that's very important, because I need to know information to the extent that it pertains to my character. So I needed to know how it was affecting Cowdy. But also, it's important to not, and this is actually something that you learn in rudimentary acting classes, but it's like, don't play the ending, right? Don't play the end. So it's actually sometimes a good idea just to watch along. Actually, technically, didn't even need to know the ending of your line, April, to play Cowdy. I needed to know what was going on with her, but I didn't need to know the end because she, as a character, isn't playing her ending, which I think is what makes her such a tragic character. She's not living in the moments where she is living in her, like the horror of what's happening to her. That's why they hit so hard, is because she tries so hard to not. But yeah, it's so hard. I cry all the time talking about your line, April, because I think it's by far the best work I've ever done in an anime series, and it probably is the best work I'll ever do in an anime series. Because every time I'm crying in that show, I was really crying. There's not a fake tear in that whole show. I would have to stop and like go to the bathroom and cry. We did a screening of the first season the first half, and I actually left early because I had to go. I just couldn't be around people. It was really tough, and I cried when the trailer, the English trailer came out. I was sitting in my room and I just lost it. That was a tangent, but yes, yeah, you're lying. Oof.
You're
picking
this.
Your job, right?
How do you feel about Persona 5
memes?
Which one's your favorite?
Oh, man. Danny DeVito, Futaba. Somebody did, like, so I'm trying to be inclusive, like, hashtag all bodies are beautiful. And they drew Danny DeVito as Futaba Sakura. And it's beautiful.
That's amazing.
Also, obviously, that Futaba is a Splatoon character.
I love all of them. Oh my god, there's so many. But I think one of my favorites is the Simpsons one, where Mo freaking love that one. I watched it so many times in a row, just like cackled. It's like, this is great. Yes, that's my favorite.
questions? Yes. Ooh, I loved it.
Yeah. I was like, ouch. That hurts, probably.
I thought it was awesome.
I didn't really realize when we were recording. think that that's what they were doing. They told me that. They were like, they like rip off a mask. And I was like, all right, that sounds whatever.
Yeah.
And then, I recorded the scene with Aunt's awakening, like, to picture. Those scenes we recorded to picture.
How do you
use them? Oh, wait. Oh, you mean with the, like, guillotine?
Yeah.
Oh, that also was scary. I always skip it because I feel bad for them. I press the little, like, crinkle the paper because I'm like, I bonded with you, you little brat. And then, bye.
My favorite anime is Helsing, so I'm fine with it. I think it's cool. What? Well, yes, I mean, Helsing Abridged is great. And actually, Neil Curtis, who voices Alucard in Helsing Abridged, he's great. From Team 4-Star, they're great guys. But Helsing, well, don't get me started on a tangent about Helsing, but we're talking about the 13-episode anime series versus the OVAs that are canon to the manga, aka Helsing Ultimate. There's a difference.
It's very intense over here. Helsing is serious.
Oh, it really is.
So, who's your favorite mascot character, Kenny or Organa?
Organa.
Yeah.
By far.
Heck,
I
yes.
mean, I haven't played Persona 4, but I like worked on the anime. Yeah.
Yeah.
And,
also,
yeah.
Futaba has a very personal relationship with Organa, so.
I'm not that far yet.
I almost consider Organa. Oh, well, Organa like her therapy animal or something. You know what I mean? Because Futaba, she has a few social issues. Just a few.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, I don't know, whatever they're having me play. It's so funny, I don't even remember. I played for like 2 years straight when I was in college, 13 hours every Sunday.
Whoa.
And I don't even remember what we were doing. I'm an actor. I just do the acting thing. But I am playing, do you guys know Hyper RPG? Any of you? Okay, I'm on Pencils and Parsecs, which is a Star Wars role-playing game with Keith Silverstein, who voices Torbjorn, ready to bark. So, yeah, I'm on that most Friday nights. I wasn't there because I'm here this week, but yeah, I never know. Version 1 of Pathfinder, is that a thing?
Yeah.
I've done that. I don't know. I just do what I'm told. I just act my little pants off. I don't take my pants off. Well, fine.
Yes.
Is it voice actors who have had influence on you, or like what sort of voice work have you also like found really interesting in films?
Oh, so many. I used to come to panels like this all the time before I was a voice actor. And when I couldn't go to panels, I would watch them on YouTube.
I did that too.
Yeah, and I was just like,
nice.
So yeah. Cool. I just want to be like them. And the people I would usually watch were like Laura Bailey, Travis Willingham. They're usually together, which then they got together. So that
it's weird that they were always together. They're not married.
I know. And like Caitlin Glass. So then getting to meet her for Love Live was like, I was like trying not to fangirl. I was like, hello, we're both in a show. Also, we both like Kyoko Kiri Kiri. No big deal. I definitely haven't been watching you on YouTube for like a creepy number of years.
yeah, that's something that I kind of put on the back burner because I'm originally from Greenville, North Carolina, so from kind of I don't want to say backwoods, not really backwoods, but you know, just like a smaller southern kind of city, and I lived there till I was 18 till I moved out to LA, and I was totally that person watching people's panels. And my first convention ever was ToraCon 2010. It was the year before I left to go to college, and I remember going in and seeing, I think Stephanie Shea and Patrick Seitz were there. And I remember going in and sitting in the back of Patrick Seitz's panel. I didn't ask any questions or anything, I was too nervous. But then, like, cut to, you know, years later, and Patrick's like a buddy of mine, and he directed me on Your Lie in April, and now he's directing me on Ohana, and it's just really crazy. Yeah, if I really sit and think about it, it's insane. Because if you told me that I would be friends with these people, like, 10 years ago, I would laugh at you. I would go, Erika, isn't that funny?
Yes. So natural. So natural. yeah, I also have to give a shout out to Tony Oliver, because he was like the one who I like randomly took a workshop with him, being like, oh yeah, voice acting was something I thought was a real thing when I was done. And then he like shook my hand and like, I remember he two-handed handshake and was like, you come back, like, you're good at this, you should switch your major. And I was like, okay!
Wow.
So he's like the reason I got started.
Tony did that, oh my gosh, I took a class with Tony when I was in college.
He can spot talent.
Dude, I took a class with him, because I heard that Bing Zoom did, did anime and stuff, and so I just took one for fun. I was finishing my theater major at UCLA, and I remember taking one, and then I was like, okay, bye, like, the class was over, uh-huh. And he goes, can you come in on Thursday? Like, can you just come in? And I was like, oh, is it, like, another class or something? He goes, don't worry about it, just come in on Thursday. And I was like,
okay.
I was like, thanks!
And he was like, you're weird, please leave.
But yeah, actually, Tony's the reason I got my first job. Yeah, everyone was like, she's never been in anything. We can't give her this show. And Tony just came out of the shadows, and he was like, I think she can do it.
Yeah.
Y'all, I'm going to beat that dead horse. I love it. I love that joke.
Yes.
For any aspiring voice actors, do you have any advice?
No. Just take acting. Classes. Honestly, that's it. Like, just become an actor. That is all you need to focus on. Acting is acting is acting. And understand the medium that you're working in. It's very important. Obviously, I'm assuming all of you know probably a little bit about anime, right? And you already play video games, right? So to understand the world that you're in when you're auditioning for these projects is very, very important. So being a fan actually helps. Right? So if I'm auditioning for Paragon, versus Your Lie in April, I'm gonna be doing something different. Like, Paragon, for those of you who don't know, was pretty naturalistic, pretty like, all right, dudes, what's up? I'm just a cool chick, and I'm gonna attack you with my thunderbolt lightnings. Thunderbolt, thunderbolt, thunderbolt! You know that YouTube video? But yeah, like that, a more naturalistic read versus like, howdy, you'll have me this time. Like, it's different. It's a different world.
Yeah, I mean, watch cartoons, play video games, when your mom's like, stop it, you just be like, I'm doing research.
You have to look at them and go, for science.
Yeah.
And they go, and then turn back.
But, like Erika said, I mean, underneath that all is an understanding of acting and knowing how to take direction and knowing, you know, how to do all that. So if you're in college, take theater classes in college. If you're not in college, find community theater, like, find classes. There's a bunch of resources you can find, but acting is at the base of it.
And also be a nice person.
Be nice.
Be good to work with. You can be not the best in the world and work all the time because you're nice. Because nobody wants to sit in a booth doing video games, like doing like battle chatter for 4 hours with you if you're a butt.
Yeah.
It's not 18 plus.
Yeah,
if you're being a butt, it can get boring. I feel like sometimes my only job is just to keep things light, because things can get rough, you know, if people are disagreeing or whatever, and you're just kind of sitting there stuck in the crossfires. It's just important to stay positive. I believe that being positive and being kind to people, and also being open to making new friends, and just I'm not good at networking as a person, but I'm very good at making. And that is, I feel like, has gotten me very, very far. Is it meaning not like, I'm very good at like connivingly making friends, as in I'm good at being friends with people and getting to know them and like learning about them and stuff.
Yeah, and I mean, like Erika mentioned, it's great to be a fan. It can help you a lot, but remember to keep it professional if you like really want to pursue voice acting. Like, I'm a huge fan of a bunch of people that I work with, and I used to work at reception at Bang Zoom, and I'd have to be like, okay, don't freak out, because some of like your favorite people are about to come in, and I'm just gonna be like, hello, what's your name? Like, I don't already know. So, you know, just be professional, be nice, really focus on improving your craft. It's not just about like, I can do a Cartman voice, that's great. But, you know, that all.
Yeah, and also you don't have to have a super interesting sounding voice to work.
No.
I am a prime example of that. I sound like I popped out of a cornfield somewhere. And I work quite a bit, and it's not because anyone's listening to my voice and going, huh, so intriguing, I've never heard that voice before. Like, I sound pretty basic.
Especially nowadays, I feel like things are gravitating more towards like real, just
that's
voices.
That's a whole another thing.
Yes?
Do you hear a song
from Spotify? Do I what?
Sorry. Do you hear a song?
A favorite song?
I like the wake up, get up,
be that one.
Yeah. But that's like the song.
Never being customized.
Oh, there's one that I heard in the game. We got to go to Atlas and see some gameplay. I forget what it's called. I don't know what it's called, though. But y'all, Persona 5, like, you guys know this, but it's so stylish. Like, you just want to stare at it all day long.
Yeah, and I think I'm going to buy the soundtrack because it's just
honestly, I probably would.
Yeah.
You know what else is a good soundtrack? All Noah Zero.
Yes.
Has a nasty good soundtrack.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my gosh. I have it on my work.
And I like, every time we would record, you know, Princess Salem would be like, I'm getting a great speech about love and peace and whatever. And then the like big song would come on and I'd be like, hold on.
In the
just
first?
This for a second.
Yeah. Do you remember when we screamed, like the first, I voiced Yuki and she's in a mech. She's cool. She's a cool mech girl, but in that first scene where they're all
beautiful chest.
No, they are. No, absolutely, you're a cool mech girl too. You're the coolest. But the first, how many of you guys know All Noah Zero? Anybody? Oh, cool, awesome. You know what? This first, I don't know if it's the first or second episode, but that music that's playing while everyone's joining together, like everybody from all the different planets are getting into their mechs, and they're like, "What? How dare they?" And like they're getting in and they're firing stuff up. Oh, I love it.
Yeah, that's great.
Also the, do you guys know Gundam Iron-Blooded Orphans?
Yes.
Dude, I was Ozzy in that. She has had some cool moments. And I love the music in that too. I just thought of the moment last season where she almost died and everyone thought she was dead. And I was like, these are the moments. This is such a tangent, but I'm gonna talk about it because I'm sitting here in front of all of you. So when Ozzy is in her mech and she almost dies, and I just had a flashback while I was recording for that to me watching Toonami at the age of 10 and turning it on, and it was, I believe, Gundam Seed or Gundam Wing, I can't remember, but it was one of those moments where one of them was about to die, and I, my little heart literally couldn't take it, so I changed the channel, but I was, and I cut back to me in the booth, and I'm like, can't change the channel now, Erika. First of all, because you're not in front of a television that you can change the channel on, but second of all, like, can't change the channel on your life, you're here. Ozzy might die, and because she's awesome. That was a horrifying explanation. But yeah, it was crazy, right? It was crazy just to know that I was now that character. That is like, did she die? Did she not? Who knows? Pocket sand.
That was a real journey you just took us on.
I know, right? I'm so well spoken. So well spoken.
I think there was a hand over, yes.
Hi, my name is Lindsay. What, if anything, in your personal life has helped you with your voice acting?
Just having human experiences.
Yeah.
Letting myself cry, experiencing loss, experiencing heartbreak. I honestly believe that just going out and being a human and having human experiences will make you a good performer.
Yeah, it's kind of a little sadistic, but having like really sad things happen in your life makes you a better actor. I like totally saw that when I was like first starting out. I was like, nothing bad has ever happened to me. And then all of a sudden I was like, here you go. And I was like, oh. But then I was a great actor. And I was like, cool. Thanks, life, I guess.
I think just being able to connect, yeah, it helps in being able to connect with those. Like with Cowdy, right, in Girl in April. Obviously I haven't been through the exact things that she's been through, but I can absolutely relate on a very base level to everything that she's gone through, so.
Yes.
Do you think they're gonna have a Persona 5 animation?
Oh, I hope so.
I sure hope so. Go out, buy the game, hopefully.
I mean, no, a lot of people already have.
They have. I think we're gonna be okay.
Yeah, I would guess, yes.
Yeah.
We really don't know anything that you guys don't know at this point.
Yeah. They just tell us to come back.
Yeah, eventually I'm hoping that they'll call us up and be like, hey, if you know we're gonna do this, and I'll be like, yay!
Yeah.
I miss us!
Yeah, dude. It'll be fun. Yeah, I think, hopefully, I heard rumblings. I hope that there's more. I mean, Persona 4 did really well, and they did so much stuff with that, so hopefully we get to revisit.
Yeah, I love that. I want to do everything from 7 and 5 all the time.
Yes.
I'll see you in Persona.
Mm-hmm.
What?
Oh, Persona RP. Gosh, so many personas.
There's a lot of personas.
Sorry, all I hear is Genji is with you. Can you repeat that? Genji is with you. But Genji is my Overwatch persona. I don't like playing with him. He is annoying. But if I had to marry him. What?
I need healing.
No, get out of here, Genji. I'm Junkrat. I can't heal you. Yes.
What's a role that you've always wanted to do, like whether it's something in the future from now, like a year or so, like you're probably not currently only in Japanese, or what's maybe a role you want to do, like for a show that you watched as a kid?
Like a specific role, or like a show or game?
Whatever you want, I mean, like...
This is such a...
I'd love to be a female lead in an Assassin's Creed type of game, or maybe a Tomb Raider type of game. That would be super fun, or something like, what is it, Horizon Zero Dawn?
Yeah. I mean, Ashley Burch crushed it as Aloy. And actually, I mean, I auditioned for Aloy, obviously. We all did. And she did an insane job. Or, like, Life is Strange or something like that. I mean, I've done small stuff in some of those heavy hitter games. But I would love to just really dive into a character, like an Ezio or an Aloy or something like that.
I mean, I just, Kingdom Hearts is my dream. Anyone in Kingdom Hearts, anything. Someday.
Do we only have 2 minutes left?
Yes.
No, we can run over 2 minutes because we were 2 minutes late. So we have 4 minutes left.
Erika has spoken. Bank Zoom did like a version of Yu-Gi-Oh's Excel.
Oh my gosh, I would list Bush 1 in Yu-Gi-Oh, you guys.
Okay.
I have such a big Yu-Gi-Oh.
I have a first edition Exodia. I own a first edition Exodia. Thank you. Heart of Cards. I've cosplayed my Valentine. I'm a happy lady in attack mode. How did you see through my own therapy strategy?
Sorry for me.
And I own an original dual disc. Bye, Felicia.
Okay, so Mixum did a version of Sexel. We did all 21 episodes and it never got released. And I played a Yu-Gi-Oh card along with some other small characters, like a bunch of cats or something. And I was like, my childhood dream of being a Yu-Gi-Oh card has finally come true. And it was like the best day. I was so happy. I like cried. And then it never, ever, ever saw
you guys
want to
know something funny? All right, it sounds like you all really do. Nobody said anything, but I'm going to say it anyway. So do you guys know Yu-Gi-Oh! GX?
Yes!
Game on, you better play cards, right? Hell yeah. I mean, heck yeah. Ooh, sorry. This is not 18+. I'm the worst. I'm so ashamed. But, okay, you want to know how nerdy I am? I was watching, Yu-Gi-Oh! GX was on TV when I was in high school, and I would watch it while I was eating my cereal before I was going to school, and I remember the day that, do you guys know Zane Truesdale?
Yes!
My husbando. Oh my gosh. He's my only Yu-Gi-Oh! Husbando, actually. I mean, the Pharaoh is like everybody's husbando, let's be real here, but not that was kind of the worst. But I remember going, and I had my AP World History exam. I broke down crying in the middle because he doesn't die, right? But we think he dies. But instead, he's going and doing those underground duels with the shock collars, and then he hurts himself, and he has a permanent heart condition. Why? And that's even worse, right? That's like even, it was very heavy for a children's card game.
Oh, yeah.
Was dying or whatever, he was dead, I didn't know how to handle it, so I started crying during my AP World History exam. Everyone thought someone had died. Well, someone really bad in my heart. That is how emotional I am. It's like, I can't keep it inside. My pants.
Alright, that's a great way to end this.
Yeah.